we're going to have a release of a chemical, a simulant. We're going to pretend it's chlorine. This is going to waft across a market square. People are going to be affected by that poison. We're going to see 121 casualties. They're going to be evacuated to a place of safety. Some of them will be decontaminated, and then they will receive emergency medical care appropriate to someone who's breathed in chlorine. We're using fire, police, military, and emergency medical services to test a whole series of new technologies that are going to revolutionize the way we deal with CBRN incidents in the future. We're here to test these technologies and to show how we can use them to save life.
We have a technology called Tag and Trace, which basically documents the entire process, the casualty journey, if you will, of all these individual casualties, and then aggregates all that information and sends it off to anybody that needs to know about it.
So we can see all that information coming through, and that's a really important piece of information for commanders who are trying to control the situation. It allows them to feed information through to the wider health system so that the hospitals know roughly how many casualties they're getting, what kind of injuries they might have, what treatment they've already had, and when they can expect them to be arriving.
We've worked exceptionally hard on trying to make sure that we can analyse breath faster and faster. So with the idea of rapidly triaging, we have managed to reduce our analysis time from 10 minutes to 40 seconds, which we can now show in this trial.
In this technology, I can treat the patients very fast, and it's a very important in this kind of accidents where we have so many patients in here. But this technology helps me a lot of this kind of accident.
Along the way, people have delighted in telling me how what we're doing is too ambitious and we will fail. But you cannot fail to learn. What's next for this project is to study the lessons learnt here today, celebrate our successes, and then comes enterprise and impact. How do you take the science and research that's been tested here today and move it towards the end user, where it starts to deliver real benefits for real patients in everyday circumstances? That's what's next.